Someone will be fired here today.
I've had many leaders who said,
yeah,
it's you or them.
Yeah.
I've never then gone and said, that man needs to get laid.
Yeah.
I didn't see a CFO mom. My mom was a teacher.
Mm.
And then she started her own business.
Things. Yeah.
Our moms were nurses, teachers. Yeah. Our grandparents were cleaning. If you were very lucky, maybe your parents are lawyers and you are in the elite group.
Yeah.
So we are the first group of CFOs, CAs, doctors, right? And obviously the corporate spaces is now opening room. I mean, it's still bad, very bad. Mm. As much as JSE listed companies still reflect or say they're improving. For me, I'm just like,
yeah,
it's not even a salt drop, we haven't even scratched the surface. But what we need to understand, are you talking about just women or black women on black women? Because it's two different.
There are layers.
Yeah, to this but thing. Let me just but start with women alone.
Yes.
We still don't have women or many women in leadership positions.
Yeah.
I mean, we can't all start new businesses. Yeah. We need to start with where we are now.
Yeah.
And as much as we'll start new things and technology has taken over and there's new startups and all that and SMEs and entrepreneurship. Yeah. At the core, the economy is still driven by the old companies.
Yeah.
So the healing that needs to happen is women have a history of pain.
Mm.
Whether it's pain they saw through their mothers or mother figures.
Yeah.
That was part of their experience growing up. Whether it was father leaving or in a home, whatever the traumas are, whether you were bullied or whether you have self-confidence issues, whatever, whatever, because people have different things that they've gone through that has defined them.
Yeah.
And now they come into workspaces and they rise to these positions that, one, didn't seem possible.
Mm-hmm.
Two, you have it, but you're still impostering syndrome there. You are figuring it out.
Yeah.
You have the pressures, self-inflicted, also the expectation to say, can a woman really be a CFO?
Yeah.
And the organization flourishes.
Because
you mentioned something that I don't get. You were saying, talking about leadership and how women's bodies and emotions, 31 days. Gone are the days. Like, if we are women in leadership and we're still saying we are emotional, there's a problem.
Yeah.
Because that is what has always been used by our male counterparts to say why women can be in leadership positions.
Yeah.
Right? I mean, in articles, you would hear if a certain female leader is doing something that people don't like, they're probably saying the same thing that a male says.
Yeah.
But when a woman says it, she's a black angry woman.
Yeah.
Or she just needs to get laid.
Yeah.
What the hell?
Why do we associate
women expressing themselves as anger when a man does it and it's okay?
Yeah, it's okay.
Because what people are confusing, my submission to my husband doesn't mean when I come to work, when I speak to a male figure, I must give you my husband's respect and submission.
No,
we are equals.
Yes,
we're equals.
Yeah.
And if you can speak your mind, why is it that when I speak my mind, she's very opinionated?
Yeah. Yes.
We never say men are opinionated.
Yes.
We never say men are angry, black or white men. Yeah. I've never heard it.
Yeah.
I've never heard someone say he needs to go get laid.
Yeah.
Like, it's not even just the female leaders that need to change their minds. It's even the people submitting to those leaders.
Yes. Yes.
Because it's a two-way thing.
Yeah.
And the same people who are saying you're a black angry woman or you're aggressive or you're opinionated, you are causing this leader trauma.
Yeah.
Where now you're going to move her from a place of speaking.
Yeah.
Not only speaking according to her job, but speak for you. Because now you're saying she's angry, right?
Yeah.
She's aggressive, right?
Yeah.
But you want in rooms where conversations about you are being heard for her to all of a sudden speak for you.
Yeah.
Also, she must be angry for you.
Yeah.
It suits you now for her to be a black angry
woman.
Yeah. I must be a black angry woman to say Mutondi should be promoted.
Yeah.
She works hard.
Yeah.
But when I'm saying I deserve to be paid
the
same as a male counterpart because I'm qualified, I do my job, and I excel.
Yeah.
I have days where if my team is not delivering, I will be angry.
Yeah.
Just like I've had male bosses come and say, someone will be fired here today. I've had men leaders who said,
yeah,
it's you or them.
Yeah.
I've never then gone and said, that man needs to get laid.
Yeah.
But if Khuthi, as a female, says, yeah, someone is getting fired here today.
Yeah, it's like
she thinks he's better.
He's an evil
guys. Evil we must boss. Stop it. Yeah. We got to stop it. We have to stop it because I always say, there's Khuthi,
yep,
the mother, wife, daughter.
Yeah,
she's very empathetic. You are a sister, ne?
Yeah,
I feel for you. I'm very empathetic, ne?
Yeah,
but then there's Khuthi, whom when she puts on the CFO cap, gender, race.
Yeah, because
feelings,
because we're doing their job. We are not doing gender things. We are doing what we are required
not to even
do.
Just gender things.
Yeah.
My role
is
not based on that I'm a female.
Yeah.
Or that I am here to anything else apart from the job description.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
If I'm doing work that is according to the job description, it's for the betterment of the organization.
Yeah.
Not the betterment of Mutondi or Khuthi.
Yes.
And when you're not a leader or you've never been in these positions, you might have opinions.
Yeah.
You might think people must do things a certain way.
Yeah.
But the organization, yes, you're part of the organization.
Yeah.
But as the CFO, I look holistically.
Yeah.
There's human element, there's financial element,
yeah,
there's ethical elements,
yeah,
there's governance elements.
Yeah.
You want to be paid how much? Okay, I'm guided by labor law.
Yeah.
And I'm gauged by the policies.
Yeah.
I'm gauged by also what your peers are being paid.
Yeah.
I can't base a decision based on Mutondi, I like you.
Yeah, no.
No.
Yeah,
but now when you think you must be given preferential treatment.
Yeah.
And I must now do whatever. I'm just giving an example.
Yeah.
And if I don't do so, I am an angry black woman. No. I don't know what I'm doing.
Yeah.
You don't know what.
You don't know what.
You don't know what I'm doing.
Yeah.
It's okay. And I don't need to explain.
Yeah.
But when it's literal, and I've experienced this, by the way.
Yeah.
I've had a female manager tell me I walk around like I know what I'm doing. And I was like, I walk around. Like, you are just a hippie. You act like you know what you're doing. And I'm like, okay, is the problem my walk? Is the problem that I'm happy? Is the problem that I don't do my job? Like, which one is which, right? But that's a story for another day. But remember the manager I said, be the change you want to see.
Yeah.
So I did experience females being funny. Wait 1 minute. I like you. You're doing great. I don't know if the problem comes when you think I'm becoming greater or I can be greater.
Yeah.
I don't know. And then things change and you're like, guys, you were okay, comfortable with me being great, but not
at your level. Yeah.
Yeah. And I don't want your job, by the way, but you didn't ask me, right? You just concluded.
Yeah.
You just don't want me being, I don't know.
Yeah.
But I then decided I'm going to be the change I want to see.
Yeah.
So the day I walk into an environment and there are women and there's a woman directly reporting to me.
Yeah.
I say, sit here.
Yeah.
Hi, I'm Khuthi.
Yeah.
What's your name? I'm Mutondi. Okay. Tell me more about yourself.
Yeah.
This. Because for me, you're not just Mutondi.
Yeah.
Okay. So there's a notion that women don't love each other.
Yeah.
There's a notion that women sabotage each other. There's a notion that if you want to bring division in an organization, put a woman and a woman together. There's a notion that we don't want good for each other. If you have that notion, kill it. Because I'm not that.
Yeah, we are not doing it
yet. I'm not competing with you.
Yeah.
I don't plan to be on this seat for long.
Yeah.
When you are ready for it and you want it, you can tell me.
Yeah.
Whatever I will pick up
Yeah.
that will get you ready for the seat,
yeah,
I will tell you.
Yeah.
Not because I'm trying to break you down.
Yeah.
But because it's my job to lead and to guide you.
Yeah.
However, I need to do it in love.
Yeah.
If at any point
Yeah.
I hurt your feelings, as as a person, not because we are women and women, because we all hurt each other's feelings, male or otherwise. Male. Let me know. Yeah. And if ever you do the same, I will let you know. And we start.
Wow.
And there have been situations where my senior manager would be like, yeah, CFO, there's a day you spoke. That day you said this, 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 this. It didn't sit well with me.
Okay.
Oh. And in your mind, you're like, defend, defend. But it made sense. Why is your... No, no, no. It's not that you're saying... It's not my... People confuse, and this also happens in marriage, but let's not go back. People want to dwell on, it's not my intention. When I say it's your intention, she's saying that's how you made her feel.
Yeah.
Your intention could have been good, but you made her feel bad. Right?
Yeah.
You might think, but it had to be said, and you might still be of the view it needs to be said. You might not need to take back what you said. You are apologizing for how it made her feel. And then you now need to explain, okay, how do we reconcile? So you don't like it when I speak this way. But what if I have to express dissatisfaction? How do you? No, rather this, this, this. Because people are different.
And sometimes it's the timing.
No. Timing is important. Timing is important. We can't delay. Because timing is also the same thing that if I tell you 6 months from now when we're doing performance review, you didn't tell me on time. There's a time for everything. But we can't delay the timing because we're not, you are not ready to handle it now. Timing is not when you're ready to handle it. Because I was actually telling my husband to see, no human being, I don't care, male or female, we always say welcome both positive and negative criticism. Mara, you're very good at saying, well done, you did well. Why I say, no one, who? Where you're like, oh, really? How deep did I mosh? I've never met anyone who welcomed with a smile. It lands in you. Really? And you wanna? Your first instinct is to say, no, but... And you can, it's okay, because it's a journey. You can't even go in defensive mode. But ultimately, if you're someone who wants to learn, you will come back to self. Just like my finance manager, like I said, you'll come back to self and say, actually, this is bad criticism, but it's intended to get me to where I want to go. And this person has good intentions, right? So I've never met her, even with God, man. Even with God, I've never. God has never told me, that's out. And I was like,
thank you for the feedback.
So it's human nature.
It's human nature. And I like what you were saying about, you know, maybe the issue is women compete, and you just feel like if Khuthadzo is shining, then it dims my light, you know, basically. So then that makes you become Khuthadzo's enemy to a certain extent. Right? So so when you have a sit down with a female colleague and say, you know, this is, we're here to work together, I want the best for you as well, then it makes them feel a bit at ease knowing that you're working for the same team, not that you need to compete and outshine each other. You're not on the opposite side, you know. So, and I think these are conversations that, you know, if you are a woman leader sitting somewhere watching this, and also if you are the one who's inflicting this as well, this is a point of reflection to say, if we have these conversations, right? Because a lot of it is based on assumption. Haven't you seen people who just dislike a certain person because they appear to be confident, they're beautiful, they, you know, and they're likable. You just don't
like them.
Until you have a conversation with them and you hear their struggles and you realize that this is a human being. They are not immune to whatever everyone else goes through. And then you're more empathetic. You now tend to love that person more. So I feel like from what you're saying, people are not having that conversation, and genuinely so, not to come and say, I'm just going to tick the box, you know, to say, you know, you can sense plastic, right? Plastic smells like fake. You can smell it
and
from
far. And it melts very quickly.
It melts very quickly.
In the fire.
Yes. Yes.
And our jobs are fire.
Are fire.
And you will manifest.
Exactly.
When
you are squeezed.
Yes.
We will see whether it's lemon or orange juice that comes out, you know. Mm. So we need to be authentic with ourselves first and foremost, you know, and build that character that allows us to start having this conversation on a genuine level to say, I love you. I want the best for you.
You don't need to say I love you if you don't love them.
Yeah, yeah. But that's what I'm saying.
I do because I do.
Exactly. But I'm saying when your character has come to a point where you can say, I love you.
And I
mean
have
it.
The genuine
for you. Love. Like, like agape kind of love. Mm. You know, not I love you, we must have tea every day. We must. No, the genuine kind of love. Of I want the best for you. Yeah. When you are hurting, I also, you know,
and there's a reason why God decided you and me must work together. There might be something you know
that
I don't know.
Yes. And let's, you know.
And I think another thing is people think being a leader means you must be a know-it-all.
Know-it-all.
When you call in the person reporting to you, and I just want to add, the words should then be followed up with actions.
Yes.
It can't just be a conversation.
Yeah.
And it
you
must
need to demonstrate,
show.
Yeah.
Yeah. So what I normally then also do, I tell all my managers, because I'm fortunate that right now I manage a team of over 40 people.
Wow.
I have five managers and a senior manager who all report ultimately to the CFO's office.
Yeah.
So I tell the managers, Mina, I don't know everything.
Yeah.
You're an expert.
Yeah.
My senior manager consolidates the expertise and then it flows to me.
Yeah.
What people value, just like any human being in a work environment, is being seen.
Yeah.
See me. Hear me.
Yeah.
But now when you have a leader who is a
I did that.
You will never hear me anywhere say, I got clean audits.
Yeah,
and it ends there. My team and I.
Yeah.
Or my team under my leadership.
Yeah.
Because there's no CFO without that whole 40
group. Yeah, that's
irrespective
true.
Of their position.
Yeah, because you can't go and do that job.
I can't do both.
Yeah.
So when we give people the ability to be good at what they do, which is what a leader does. You empower and you develop that everyone, if you are the one capture at your highest, best level. If you are the one release. If you are the accounts payable at your best. If you are an expert, technical, be the best.
Yeah.
Do we need to take you to training? Yeah. But now, if I want to sit there and try and learn everything, I won't be a leader.
No.
I will then end up getting too involved in the
in
detail.
In operational, yeah.
Yeah. It's important. I must still know. I must still know. And that's why you need to be prepared. Because no one can bullshit me about payroll.
Yeah.
No one can bullshit me about text.
Yeah.
No one can tell me. Sorry, guys. I'm still working on the story thing.
Yeah.
It's a weakness. It's a known weakness. We're working on it. And I blame audit. Yo, I learned
I know that.
I learned these things in audit. Anyways, you can't come and lie to me.
Yeah.
Let's learn now.
Yeah.
Don't need to wait for tomorrow. I can't lie now. You can't lie to me about certain things because I've gone through that journey.
Yes.
However, if I see, not to say you are lying intentionally, but it's also my job to identify gaps.
Yes.
Which, okay, they're not lying. They honestly just don't know.
Yeah.
And it's important to also understand the level where your team is.
Mm.
Every individual is different. And even in their career development, they're in different levels.
Yes.
I can't expect an executive person. I can't talk with an executive level.
Uh-huh.
The same way as a junior.
Yeah.
And I held a finance workshop with my team last year. I took them through. I asked them, have you ever looked at the financial statements? Our financial statements.
Yeah. No.
Okay. Okay, not the full of financials. Yeah. Where your section rolls up in the financial statement. Yeah. That line I said, have you looked at it? No. Okay. But audit every year you do it. Yeah. Okay. All right. Okay. Let's break it down. Because what I learned is that when I was still a junior.
Yeah.
Doing articles.
Yeah.
What made me ask too many questions.
Yeah.
Is because I like understanding how things fit.
Yes.
Now you're just there. You're given accounts payable.
Yeah.
You have no idea what you learned or improve up.
Yeah.
Accounts and payable comes with you. There's an also. Expense. We owe somebody. Yeah. That's why we have accounts payable.
Yeah.
But I don't know. You're just given workbook and it has cross.
Yeah.
And now my mind doesn't work like that.
Yeah.
So in an environment where someone does not identify, this girl is curious and she needs big picture as much as she does detail.
Yeah.
I'll be said, she's stupid.
Oh, yeah.
She asks too many questions.
Yeah. Yeah.
And then you'll have the person who just does detail does and enjoys it.
Yeah.
Then they just stick into the workbook.
Mm.
You're like, excellent.
Mm.
But you are confusing things.
Yeah.
So I then talked them through. I can't say, well, this is what the line you do.
Yeah.
It's
yeah.
Nina, credit. There's your bank. There's your receivable.
Yeah.
Those are the two lines.
Yeah.
Nina, whatever. Yeah. This is where.
Yeah.
The impact of what you're doing daily.
Yeah.
Because in our profession, for accountants, sorry for those who are not, in our profession, people like thinking audit happens during audit. Audit happens every day.
Yeah.
If no miracle will happen during the audit if the miracle is not happening daily. Because what is audited is the day-to-day transactions. Yeah. You have no idea what the auditors are going to choose.
Yes.
So if you are saying you got a nice, clean audit, it means you were clean every day.
Yeah.
But now, sometimes you need to take time with your team. And I can't express this enough. And build a space where they feel free to talk to you.
Yeah. Yeah.
Because another thing, maybe because me and I've moved around a lot, so I'm used to getting in a position where I'm like, I don't know this place. I don't know what your culture is. I don't know what you guys do. Teach me. If you are my next report or you even applied for this job and didn't get it.
Yeah.
It's not to mean a... You don't know.
Yeah. Right? Yeah, that's true.
And I'm the least knowledgeable about this place.
Yeah, right now.
I'm not accounting. I don't know nothing.
Yeah.
It's you who must teach me.
Yeah.
Oh, this is what we do. This is our timeline. Mm. Oh, okay. Oh, okay. What would you like to help me with? Or which portions? How would you want us to work?
Because
this is how I work.
Mm.
How do you like to work?
Mm.
Do you like a manager who's like, quick,
yeah, every day.
What do you like?
Yeah.
This is what I like. Oh, okay. This is how I work.
Mm.
Okay, how do we meet each other?
Yes.
And then we arrange, we agree. Okay, this is how we'll work.
Mm.
And then we give it a shot. And if we need to adjust.
Along the way, yeah.
Get feedback. Mm. I get feedback from my teams.
Yeah.
So when I'm doing their performance review, I will tell them, what is it that you believe I'm doing as a CFO?
Yeah.
You're doing this. Great. Because everyone wants to tell a leader they're doing well. What am I not doing?
Okay.
That I think I should do.
Okay.
That's a tough one. Because what? People don't even think about that. Because leaders don't ask for feedback.
Yes. Because that's true.
You want to just be great. When are you just dish criticism?
Yeah.
Positive or none?
Yo.
No, guys. Receive.
Yeah, receive.
Because I'm also a work in progress.
Yeah.
The CFO 28 and the CFO 32, completely different.
Yeah.
And I was made by growth and circumstances.
Yes.
I've had to take employees through CCMA. I've never had a running stomach like those 2 weeks.
Sure.
Because as a person, as Khuthi, I don't want to do this.
Yeah.
But I don't.
Yeah.
But as an employer.
Yeah.
I've given you all I can give.
Yeah.
We have to go through this process.
Yeah.
It was tough.
Yeah.
Because I loved that person as a sister. I'm sure wherever they are now, they still think, that girl. But I had done all I could.
Yeah.
But I have to take off the head of Khuthi, empathy, sister,
yeah,
to be
follow due process.
What must I do?
Yeah.
And it's always easy when it's being done by a man. Mm. But the minute it becomes a woman.
Yeah, it's like
she's not emotional. No, but she doesn't feel.
Yeah. Why doesn't she feel for that for person's someone family? Else. Hey, blah.
You know, I'm not here for my feelings, guys. Yeah. My feelings are not irrelevant. And I'm telling you, it was so bad, I needed to go for coaching.
Wow.
And I was already on coaching because, again, remember the time I got sick? Yes, I said I was doing life coaching where I was doing practicals to become a life coach. But I actually had a life coach for my career.
Yeah.
Because I was also confused. Like, Lord, how did I get so stressed to a point of sickness?
Yeah.
As a leader.
Yo.
Wow. And if I'm not resting, am I allowing my teams to rest?
Yeah.
Or the same expectations I have on myself, I'm now putting it on others.
Yeah.
My second CFO role, I remember even the ladies are like, yeah, Khuthi, it's easy for you because you are single. And I'm like, hey, banna. Okay. But now, let's pause and we'll look back. Are you working at night and expecting people to work at night? Because when are
because
you
Because you have time.
And the answer was no.
Mm.
Everyone, I don't follow you up and say work at night.
Yeah.
No. You know your deliverables.
Yeah.
I teach you prioritize.
Yeah.
Plan your life.
Yeah.
Plan what you're going to do when. But if I don't get any of the deliverables and I don't get a reason why the deliverable was not delivered, if you planned you will work at night, that's not me saying work at night.
But isn't it like when you work at night and then maybe you send emails and, you know,
those
doesn't
are two
that...
different things. So me sending emails at night.
Yeah.
If I work at night better, yeah, I would have told you in our conversations.
Okay. Okay.
That early, the first day, yeah, you meet me. Oh, yeah. Mina. And it's true, Shem. Mina, I can wake up. I have insomnia.
Yeah.
I have insomnia for now.
Yeah.
I have insomnia. So, and I work best at night. Even yeah, when I was a student, I studied better at night.
Mm.
So when others were going to library, I would go sleep at rest, wake up, eat, and my night shift would start.
Yeah.
I'm better at night.
Yeah.
I'm praying for a job in the future way. Anyways, I'm not a morning 5 a.m. club.
Yeah.
Miss me with that. Miss me with that. Even my husband and we are similar. We enjoy waking up. Now we have a kid, obviously. And the most frustrating thing is this child just wakes. And I'm like, we are pinned on.
Yeah.
It is
this hour.
Can we? Oh, but anyways, I work better at night.
Yeah.
So if I open my emails and send an email at 3 a.m., I'm not expecting you to be up. But if you are up, and most people don't have emails on their phone.
Yeah.
I have emails on my phone.
Yeah.
I literally, and it's something that, yo, Jehovah, I'm still working on.
Yeah.
And that's why I need a life coach. Because Mina, I work. Like my husband will tell you, I'll say we're going for dates,
yeah,
lunch or date night. My emails, if I get an email, I want to respond now.
Yo?
Like, I don't have the,
yeah.
And then they'll be like, this email can wait. But I'm like, yeah, but then it's adding to tomorrow's list.
Yeah.
I wanna.
Yeah.
And it is still linked to the, because I was in a pace, I'm at a pace where, that's just me. I like, let's
yeah,
finish.
Yeah.
Let's do.
Yeah.
So I don't like people who drag.
Hmm.
Don't drag your feet. Mm. Excellence, my team knows. Excellence.
Yeah.
Communicate. You are a support function. Finance is support. You can't be silent.
Yeah.
Even if you're not going to give an answer, acknowledge that you received.
Yeah.
The day must not, you go 2 hours without checking your emails and you're going to focus on this Excel spreadsheet.
Yo.
You won't even go, no guys, we can't. And then how are we support? Because support is like IT.
Yeah.
If you call and say, I can't log on to my system, you expect someone to give you login.
Yeah.
But if you can help me log in, at least tell me when you'll help me.
Yeah.
You can't just be silent.
Yeah.
I don't know now. Do I call your boss and say you are non-responsive?
Yeah.
You get me?
Sure.
So, me sending emails at 3 a.m. is not a request for you to do things at 3 a.m.
Yeah.
Because
okay,
there's timelines.
Yeah. And I feel like, for me, I'm just thinking of my quiet, shy self, maybe when I was still training. You know, to say, I used to get anxiety, especially on Monday mornings, because I would know that maybe my manager was working over the weekend. So you're like holding your breath to say, you know, what email am I going to see today? You know, because nobody communicated that whatever that I send you on the weekend, right, is something that I feel like you need to attend immediately. You know, so I just felt like because my manager is working, like even when I am doing my own thing on the weekend and I remember that, oh, my manager might be working. So
you want I might need to check your laptop.
Yes, I might need to check. You know, because we are not communicating to say, look, I'm just catching up on my work as a manager. I am not expecting, you know, it just makes it a bit funny.
But it's a two-way. I mean?
It's a two-way.
Because you could have, the first time you had heart palpitations,
yeah,
you could have said, ma'am, when you send emails on weekend, do you expect me to do it over the weekend?
Yeah, thank you. Thank you for that. But remember,
you're still a trainee.
You are still a trainee. Mm. And someone is like your parent, a parent and a child.
Yes,
right?
Yes.
You don't necessarily expect your child to be the one who points out, you know.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah, you're a different child.
You, no, but I'm just saying,
you know, my
general,
mom is probably like, you're Jehovah, this child you have given me.
You are special. You're special.
No, I'm not special.
Yeah, but I'm just saying that in general.
Other
in
people.
General. And they don't point it out because they don't know better. Because your parents, with more experience, obviously. You know, even though you can be the smartest kid in the room, you can never
and
have
also
as
respect.
Much experience.
And respect.
And respect.
Yeah.
You know, so maybe these are the things that, the conversation that needs to be had. You know,
but I will be honest, I had the same experience as you. Don't take my current response because this is...
And you survived it. But we know there are trainees who are going through depression because of exactly that. You know, so this is a reflection point for those who find themselves in managerial positions, in leadership positions, to say, it doesn't hurt to communicate. You know, to say, even if I sent an email, to just follow it up with a call to say, I just sent you an email.
If it's urgent, tell me.
Yeah, tell me if it's urgent. And also some of the emails, the tone in writing
is different.
It's not as kind as me picking up the phone call and, you know, crack a little joke before I tell you that, oh, I sent you an email. You know, when you get a chance, please look at it. Yes, or even a voice note. Now we use WhatsApp voice note. Hey, you know.
You are taking, you are... Hitting traumas.
Yeah.
You are hitting traumas.
Yeah. So but it's also coming as a reflection point on myself as well to say, this is what I would have appreciated for someone that, you know, I was reporting to.
So you see this tone, language, email, it's people who have not healed.
Yeah.
And the question I would ask myself, and I would prompt anyone who of us, because I also have been there,
yeah,
right, where you just have panic mode and you don't know what this person is going to say during reviews.
Yeah,
you don't know. I mean, I had moments where I would be called you, like, you, what are you doing?
Yeah.
And I'm like,
yeah,
Mina,
yeah, I mean, oh, I am you, you now.
Everyone has a name, but
yeah,
me.
But
so they didn't heal.